I'm here with Layman Brewster, who tells me about the days when he traveled with Diego Corrales.
Yeah, Diego, that was my boy. We used to roommate together when we traveled the world on the U.S. Olympic team.
You're kidding.
94 to 96. Yes, sir.
Wow, that's huge. Was he a funny guy, sense of humor?
Oh, yeah, man, you know what? He was just a nice, frail dude. Like, he wasn't no tough dude. He was just a nice dude, man. So then when he became a professional, he kind of blossomed, like his wings spread, you know. Not to say he became a different person, but he still was the same humble, nice person, man. But, you know, just, I don't know, man. I'm still hurt that I lost him. So, you know, I won't talk about him too long. I'll get teary-eyed, but, you know.
You know, people love him, though. Why do people love Diego Corrales so much? What was it about
him? Because he was a good spirit. Because Diego, he represented goodness. You know, light attracts light, and people that has positivity in their life, they pick up on that. You know, he don't come, you know, you ever talk to somebody and you feel like, oh, they looking at me like they got some ulterior motive. That ain't him. His thing was love and let love and live and let live. You know, he's...
So you knew a lot of great ones because you knew him. Who else was on that team when you guys traveled?
Oh, my gosh, man. Wow. David Reed, Antonio Tarver, there was Clay Bay, Lance Whitaker, Fernando Vargas.
How funny was Vargas? He had a great sense of humor.
Oh, my gosh, man.
Did he ever hide your gloves or put a...
Nah, I told you the dude almost got us killed down in... It was 94, the U.S. Olympic... U.S. We were in the... what do you call it? The Pan American Games. And I was the team captain. And he was the only one that spoke Spanish. Well, Diego spoke Spanish, but he wouldn't translate. Anyway, matter of fact, he was in the ring fighting. So there were three rings, and somebody was fighting. I think it was Diego. And, you know, everybody hates America. For whatever reason, when we fight, I don't care if we fighting. It don't matter. They against us. So everybody went in Buenos Aires, right?
Argentina.
And man, he's sitting up there, everybody killed Americans. And so, you know, we cheering on our fighter, fight, whatever. The only one out of the whole is 12 of us, right? Well, one is in the ring, well, so it's 11 of us. The only one that wasn't even paying attention to the fight was Fernando. He's speaking Spanish to all the Spanish. Because we in Argentina, and whatever he said, it's like everybody stopped watching the fight and just got up. Like, I mean, we talking about 2,000-3,000 people in the venue. They start running straight at us. They want to kill us.
What did he tell us? Did you ask him? Hey, friend?
I asked him last year. I was like, man, what did you say? He's like, man, they was talking crazy about us, so I had to represent America. So he didn't go into detail about it, but I'm sure it was some explicit.
He went Oxnard
word.
On them.
He went Oxnard. Yeah. So, man, they had a security around the bus. They was throwing bricks and bottles at the bus, man. They were trying to set the bus on fire. I'm telling you, dude, they had to take us back to our village for the Americans, and we had security. I mean, dude, seriously, they wanted to kill us, man. Fernando, you almost got us killed, sucker.
So how did you guys do in that tournament?
Oh, we did good, man. I got a silver medal. That's when I fought Felix Yvonne. I had the flu. It was the flu. I had the flu, got the silver medal anyway. Knocked out everybody up into that fight. Let's see here. Tarver, that's when he beat that Cuban, man, light heavyweight. He was like 6'7". That ain't even heard of to be 175 pounds, 6'7". But Tarver beat him, and that's when he really started to make his name. Gosh, what did David Reed do? He did good. There was, I think, Michael Sims. He did good. There's a few of us that did good, man.
Fernando, did he do okay?
I don't remember what Fernando did now. Think about it, man. Only thing I remember is he almost got his heels. I'm like, I ain't gonna see my mama.
What do you have to tell Fernando now if he's watching this video, which he probably will be doing?
Man, I just wanna say I love you, brother. I love you, man. And, you know, thank you for giving me great memories, man. And thank you for just help motivating me. And I hope I motivated you because, you know, we made it. We both became world champions. So thank you, brother. I always love you.
He was the youngest champion in history.
Was
in his weight class, yeah.
Was he really? Hey, you know, man, it was something about him always, even in amateurs, man. He just had that, you know what I mean? It was like you always got on any, in any sport, you got that one player that you know is going to be successful, and that was definitely Fernando Vargas, man.
We have Elaine Bruce to talk about Fernando Vargas and Diego Corrales. Stay tuned for more. FeasibleReport.com from the Fighting Connection Gym in West Los Angeles. What are your hours here, Elaine?
I'm here from 12 to 8 every day. It's 11, 912, Mississippi. It's, the cross street is Olympic and Bundy.
Olympic and Bundy, right here in West Los Angeles. FeasibleReport.com. Millie Stakeback reporting.